Hey everyone. In the last video, we went through an introduction to numerical integration. Now, let's begin looking at our first type of numerical integration that you are likely already familiar with, that being Riemann sums. If you recall from your Calculus 1 course, you were probably taught Riemann sums, as they are commonly used to introduce the idea of integrals to new students. To review this topic, let's imagine that we are given a function e to the power of negative x squared, which is one function that cannot be integrated and solved analytically no matter how hard you were to try. So what do we do if we want to know the area under this curve between points A and B? Well, we can use numerical integration, and specifically for this video, we can use Riemann sums to approximate this solution. But how do we actually go about doing that? Well, Riemann sums approximate the area under a curve by dividing the area into small segments and approximating each segment's area using rectangles. For now, let's just assume that all of our segments are the same width. We would then sum up the areas of all these rectangles to get an approximate total area under the curve, which we can see here. The validity of this approximation will depend on how much error we get, which is a sum of all these little chopped off areas that you can see here. We'll elaborate more on this in the next video called Riemann Sums Error Analysis. Looking at our rectangles here, the area of each rectangle is easy to find, as it is simply going to be the height of the rectangle, which is our function evaluated at A in this first rectangle here, times the width, which is just going to be our step size, or delta x. Briefly though, in this example, we only use the top left-hand corner of our rectangle to approximate the integral. What if we use the right side, or even the midpoint of the rectangle? Well, these are all valid ways of conducting Riemann sums, and they are called the left Riemann sum, the middle Riemann sum, or the right Riemann sum. So let's go through the theory of these three methods now. Let's begin with our left Riemann sum, which is also known as the left rule. As shown earlier, in this method, the left part of our rectangle will go up until it hits the curve, then straight over and down. I will write out the general formula for our left Riemann sums here with the meaning of each of these variables. Because we are using the left Riemann sum, the left base point will be evaluated, and that will be our height. Then we can multiply that by our base, which is again our change in x. Then the total area would be the summation of all of our rectangles together. As you can imagine, with smaller and smaller changes in x, or said another way, with a limit approaching infinite rectangles, we get the analytical definite integral, or said another way, the exact answer with no error. I will now write out the equation for left Riemann sums if we have unequal step sizes here. Meaning if our rectangles are differing in size, we'll use this equation. If all of our rectangles are taken to be the same width, then we can condense the formula by factoring out our delta x term, since all of these terms share that value. Usually this is written like so, where delta x is simply our upper limit of integration, commonly called b. A is our lower limit of integration, and n is our number of segments. One thing to note about the left Riemann sums is that they underestimate when we have an increasing region of our function, and then they overestimate when we have a decreasing region of our function. Just keep this information in mind, as it'll be important when we begin to talk about the error produced by each type of Riemann sum in the coming videos. Next, let's talk about the right Riemann sum, also known as the right rule. Here our area of each rectangle will be found in a similar way by multiplying our base, which is our step size, times our function's output when using the right side of the rectangle's x value as an input, which you can see here. Writing out the general right Riemann sums formula, you can see that we are now using xi instead of xi minus 1, as we want to begin our summation from x1, as you can see here on our graph on the left. Now, let's write out the equation for right Riemann sums if we have unequal step sizes. To reiterate, this means if our rectangles do not all share the same base, or the same delta x. If all our rectangles do share the same delta x, then we can condense this formula again by factoring out our delta x term just like we did for the left Riemann sum. One thing to note about these type of Riemann sums is that they overestimate when we have an increasing region of the function, and then they underestimate when we have a decreasing region of the function. Lastly, let's talk about middle Riemann sums, also known as the midpoint rule. Here, our area of each rectangle will be found by multiplying our base, just like we did for the other two methods. And this will be multiplied by the outpoint of the middle of a rectangle, hence the name midpoint rule. Writing out our general middle Riemann sum formula, you can see that we are now using the midpoint, so xi plus xi minus 1 divided by 2. Now, let's write out the equation for middle Riemann sums if we have unequal step sizes, just like we did for the other ones. If all of our rectangles here are taken to be the same width, we can again factor out this delta x term and move it to the outside of our summation term. One thing to note here about these types of Riemann sums is that they can both overestimate and underestimate the actual integral value, depending on the concavity and behavior of the function within each subinterval. As I stated earlier, in the coming videos, we will talk about the error analysis of each Riemann sum method and go through several examples for each to round out your understanding of this numerical integration technique. I hope that this video helped your understanding of the theory and gave you an intuitive understanding of the left, right, and middle Riemann sums. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I'll do my best to address your concerns.